Hey, how's it hanging, guys? It's Eric here, and these are my top 10 facts about Serpent Mangle in Five Nights at Freddy's AR Special Delivery. So up at number 10 is, of course, Serpent Mangle has been released on Friday, March 5th, 2021. So yeah, she is one of the first character skins to appear in March of 2021. She's come right after Blackheart Bonnie and Heartsick Baby from the Heartstoppers event. And off number 9 is that Serpent Mangle is the Mangle's second ever skin in Five Nights at Freddy's AR Special Delivery. In the Mangle's skin spectrum, Serpent Mangle has appeared right after Magician Mangle. And now for number 8 is that Serpent Mangle is the 28th character skin in Five Nights at Freddy's AR Special Delivery. In the overall skin spectrum, she's appeared right after Blackheart Bonnie and Heartsick Baby. Anyway, something interesting about Serpent Mangle's debut in FNAF AR is that she's actually appeared alongside another new skin, that being Curse Springtrap. And then for fact number 7 is that Serpent Mangle has the same mechanics as original Special Delivery Mangle. So yeah, nothing new here. The Mangle's mechanics in FNAF AR is that she will wander around the environment. She will continuously charge towards you, and after a bit, she will begin falling apart. You are then tasked to find dropped parts within a specific randomized time limit, and when complete, during her next charge, you'll then automatically emit a controlled shock on her. I don't know if you need to be wearing the Freddy mask for this, but either way, I'd make sure to wear it just to be on the safe side. And now for fact number 6 is that Serpent Mangle haywires with red eyes. When this happens, just do what you'd normally do against Mangle. Put your Freddy mask on and look away. Serpent Mangle does not have any unique behavior regarding her haywire. And now for fact number 5 is that Serpent Mangle charges with orange eyes. You can see this when she's charging cloaked under Anim Stealth or proposed with the real attack. To fend yourself against this attack, just put your Freddy head on and look away. Either way, you'll have two orange eyes thrusting your way. Well, three, including her extra head single eye, I guess. And then for fact number 4 is that Serpent Mangle is actually incredibly multicolored. Multicolored to the extreme, if you will. I believe she is to reference creatures such as dragons and other mythical snake-like reptiles. Perhaps all the colors are to reference chameleons and custom to the art of camouflage. And off number 3 is that Serpent Mangle appears to have a flower petal neck piece consisting of orange and light turquoise petals. Quite interesting to see that on her. However, I fail to see what it has to do with ancient reptiles. Unless I'm missing something, but either way, I'm not complaining. I honestly couldn't see this skin without it now. And speaking of which, similar to this, she actually has somewhat of an orange and white fiery tail. This aspect is much more dragon-like, so yeah, really cool. Enough number 2 is, just like Magician Mangle, Serpent Mangle also appears to have multicolored eyes. Oh, wait, this also goes with the fact that her entire body is multicolored. What do you know? But anyway, I believe this will become a repeating trend with skins for the Mangle, which I personally do enjoy. Very unique, I must say. Anyway, her left eye is entirely orange, like just one solid orange ball. And her right eye is also orange, but it actually glows yellow, so when both her eyes glow, they'll appear multicolored. So yeah, interesting. Oh, and yes, her extra head only has one eye, and its eye is also orange, but glows yellow. And off number 1 is that Serpent Mangle is actually holding two minuscule props, representing the sun and moon. She's holding the sun in her left hand, and the moon in her right hand. This may actually be in commemoration to her eyes, because her left eye is fully orange, just like how the sun can be interpreted as fiery orange, as well as the moon in her right hand, mixing with her right eye being yellow, in which the moon can be illustrated as yellow sometimes. But yeah, as usual, I could just be looking too much into this. Either way, interestingly enough, both the sun and the moon remain in her hands while in game. Anyway, there is a reason why she is holding the sun and moon, and that is that every year around both March and September, an event in which the sun is symmetrically centered directly above the equator comes along. This series of events is called an equinox. But anyway, guys, hope you guys did enjoy this. If you did, why not leave a like? And if you have not already, why not subscribe for more Five Nights at Freddy's videos, like top 10s, theories, news videos, let's play, stuff like that. And if you want to be first to those videos, why not study that bell down below? And yeah, with all that being said, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have an absolute fantastic rest of your day. And with all that being said, I hope to see you guys in the next video. Stay fresh.